Justice Ogola, please introduce yourself and let us know the program for the 3rd of June.
Thank you very much. Viewers, my name is Canon Justice James Ogola. I'm in the organizing committee here at Namugongo. As you know, it's the Eastern Cluster of Dioceses that are organizing this event this year, and we have lots of committees. And one of the committees is publicity and media. And I happen to be the chair of that committee. And this year we are fully satisfied with you members of the media. We have so many media houses here that have been collaborating with us every day of this week. And they are going to be here all through to D-Day on Saturday. We appreciate that very much.
Thank you so much. Can you please tell us what's the message for this year's 3rd June?
The message should be, come, share in the tribulation that these very courageous witnesses gave, the example that they left with us. 130 years ago, 45 young men were martyred here. They were tortured, they were killed. They were then roasted on the fiery furnace, and their ashes are here. So although they died almost 130 years ago, they still live. They are alive today here. Their spirit is hovering over us in the company of other saints. And we want the pilgrims who are coming here to share in that one. But their one thought is, come. Remember the memory of these courageous men who gave the ultimate sacrifice, their own life. What are you going to do? The memory of those people should be to encourage us to rekindle our own faith, to refuel our own stand, spiritual stand, to reignite, to refuel, to resurrect our own commitment and devotion to our walk with the Lord Christ.
Justice, what do you think is the biggest problem the church has faced since COVID-19, and what are we doing as Christians to revive the church?
The COVID set in a cold stream, a cold wind blew across the face of the church. For the first time in the history of this planet, churches were closed. That had never ever happened before, and we pray it never ever happens again. And with that cold wind blowing, the people's spirit went down with it. People who used to come and fellowship in public were now restricted to their own homes and their own houses. So slowly they are coming out. But our prayer is that they will come in masses, and events like this one of Saturday, when we see masses of people coming here, we are very much encouraged. When we see people coming from every corner and every nook of Uganda and beyond to come to be pilgrims here, we are very much encouraged. And we have a wonderful thing for you on D-Day. We have a mass choir here. We have 400 choristers, a choir of 400 people from the East. They're going to be singing in as many languages of the East, maybe 30 languages. So in a sense, we are resurrecting the Pentecost here, because tongues will be singing the praise of our Lord. And that's a great thing for the revival of the church after COVID.
Thank you so much, Justice. It was an honor speaking to you this evening. We wish you a great service. Thank you. That is what we will have here for you. I was still having more guests to speak to, but for now, that's it.